Number 10. Doggo Argentino. As the name suggests, the Doggo Argentino was bred in Argentina in 1928. The breeder, Antonio Nores, used an array of 10 other breeds, among them the Great Dane and the Cordoba dog, which is extinct today, to obtain the Doggo Argentino. Despite exhibiting steadfast bravery and willingness to protect its human companion, the Doggo Argentino was bred primarily for the purpose of big game hunting, including wild boar. They appear as a large, white, muscular breed of dog, with the males weighing between 40 to 45 kilograms, while the females being slightly lighter at 35 to 40 kilograms. They are considered exceptionally good guard dogs and are known for protecting their family and home. They tend to be unwilling to accept strangers, so they need to be cautiously introduced to new people. Doggo Argentino tend to be okay with other dogs, but they were bred as a fighting dog breed, so they may be increasingly aggressive towards other dogs. In that same vein, however, they were bred to work with other dogs when hunting. So many are okay with dogs they have been raised with or introduced to. Doggo Argentino are considered one of the most aggressive dog breeds in the world. Since the breed's inception, these dogs were used as fighting dogs and were bred from fighting dogs. Of the most bizarre incidents of attack is the one where a Doggo Argentino dog by the name of Max bit the face of a news anchor, Kyle Dyer, on live TV on Valentine's Day 2012. Because of their aggressive tendencies, the Argentine Doggo is banned or has ownership restrictions in certain countries, including the Cayman Islands, Denmark, Fiji, Iceland, Australia, New Zealand, Singapore, Turkey, and Ukraine. In the United Kingdom, under the Dangerous Dogs Act 1991, it is illegal to own a Doggo Argentino without lawful authority. The Doggo Argentino is not a good first-time dog and should only be owned by experienced dog handlers. Number 9. American Pit Bull Terrier. The American Pit Bull Terrier is a medium-sized, intelligent, short-haired dog of a solid build, whose early ancestors came from the British Isles. The American Pit Bull Terrier was used in blood sports, like bull and bear baiting, where packs of dogs were set against bigger animals in a pit. It was bred with fighting in mind. Color patterns that are typical in the breed are solid and tuxedo. American Pit Bull Terriers are not a good choice for people who can give them little or no attention. They must be trained and socialized when young to overcome the breed's tendencies towards stubbornness and bossiness, which combined with his strength can make him hard to handle if he hasn't learned that you are in charge. While they might not start a fight, they'll never back down from one, and they fight to the finish. Hence, the American Pit Bull Terrier must be kept on a leash in public to prevent aggression towards other dogs. It's not a good idea to let these dogs run loose in dog parks. American Pit Bulls, who aren't properly socialized as puppies, can become aggressive towards other dogs. In February 2020, a Massachusetts man, Joshua Jejusing, met his end from a fatal crossbow wound after his neighbor tried to use the weapon to save him from being mauled by two male American Pit Bull Terriers. Police had to shoot down the two aggressive dogs. 12 countries in Europe, as well as Australia, Canada, Ecuador, Malaysia, New Zealand, Puerto Rico, Singapore, and Venezuela, have enacted some form of breed-specific legislation on American Pit Bull Terriers, ranging from outright bans to restrictions and conditions on ownership. The state of New South Wales in Australia places restrictions on the breed, including mandatory sterilization. The breed is banned in the United Kingdom, in the Canadian province of Ontario, and in many locations in the United States. And if you think that the American Pit Bull Terrier is not the Frankenstein of dogs, the number one will definitely awake the cynophobia trait in you. Number 8. Fila Brasileiro. The Fila Brasileiro, also known as the Brazilian Mastiff, is a large working breed of dog developed in Brazil. It is known for its superb tracking ability, aggressiveness, and an unforgiving, impetuous temperament. In Portugal, the verb filar literally means hold or arrest. And thus, rather than attacking its prey, the Fila Brasileiro traps it and waits for the hunter to arrive. Owing to these qualities, the Fila Brasileiro is used as a guard dog, as a kettle dog for livestock, and as a hunting dog for tracking and controlling a large game. There is a reason why they say Faithful as a Fila exists in Brazil. The Brazilian Mastiff was bred to be loyal only to their owners, which means that consistent and early socialization is key to raising a Fila Brasileiro who won't become aggressive around visitors or strangers. The Fila Brasileiro may not take well to other kids, like playmates, so it is important to set up boundaries for both the dog and kids. Additionally, Filas can get along with other dogs their size, but tend to view anything smaller as prey. Even with consistent training, Filas are hardwired to chase down small animals, like cats and smaller pups, and will likely be best suited as the only animal in the home. In March 2013, Jade, a pupil at the Fred Longworth High School in Tildesley, Manchester, was mauled to death by aggressive and out-of-control dogs, among them, two Brazilian Mastiffs in Wigan. In Fiji, the United Kingdom, Norway, Malta, and Cyprus, it is illegal to own any of these dogs without specific exemption from a court. In Australia, in the states of Queensland, New South Wales, Victoria, South Australia, and Western Australia, the Fila is a restricted or prescribed breed. Imports are also prohibited. They are automatically classified as a dangerous dog in New Zealand and Trinidad and Tobago, meaning they cannot be imported and males must be neutered. Number 7. Tosa Inu. The Tosa Inu, also commonly known as the Japanese Mastiff, is a breed of dog of Japanese origin that is considered rare. In Japan, the Tosa Inu is considered a national treasure and often referred to as the sumo wrestler of the dog world. This is not a noisy breed, as it was once used for dog fighting and was bred to fight quietly, as Japanese dog fighting rules called for silence. This natural guard dog is protective, courageous, and fearless. It needs an owner who knows how to display leadership at all times. In May 2019, an elderly man, Tsutomu Fukumoto, from Western Japan, died after he was bitten by a Tosa Inu dog that he was tending to. Ownership of Tosa is legally restricted in certain jurisdictions. A specific exemption of a British court is required to own and import Tosas legally in the UK. The breed is banned or legally restricted at a national level in Australia, Denmark, Fiji, Iceland, Republic of Ireland, Romania, Malaysia, Malta, New Zealand, Norway, Singapore, Tunisia, United Arab Emirates, United Kingdom, and Israel. Number 6. Presa Canario. The Presa Canario, also known as the Canary Mastiff, is a large dog breed originally bred for working livestock. The name of the breed is Spanish, means Canarian catchdog. The history of the Presa Canario is carefully recorded, evoking mystique and awe for the breed. It is the animal symbol of the island of Gran Canaria. Muscular, fearless, and attentive, this dog was bred for work. Farmers on the island were continually dealing with packs of feral dogs that would attack their livestock. The Presa was the answer and became the ultimate protector. These dogs are loyal to their family, obedient and docile, and are extremely devoted to the master, but are very aloof and suspicious of strangers. This dog breed is not for everyone and not for first-time owners, so you've got to be sure that this is the right dog breed for you and that you will be able to control it. The famous death of an American lacrosse player and coach, Diane Alexis Whipple, in January 2001, was on account of dog attack. The dogs involved were two Presa Canarios, a male named Bane and a female named Hera. Importation and sale of the breed is prohibited in Australia and New Zealand. Number 5. Boer Bowl. The Boer Bowl is the only South African dog breed created to defend the homestead. The word Boer Bowl derives from Boer, Afrikaans for farmer, and Bowel, Old Afrikaans for dog. Boer Bowl therefore translates as farmer's dog. Despite the Boer Bowl's long breeding history, there is great uncertainty as how many and which breeds were used to create it. It is generally believed that the breed was created from inbreeding native African Landrace dogs, such as the Afrikaans. With breeds brought into South Africa by Dutch, French, and British settlers. The Boer Bowl is a large dog with a strong bone structure and well-developed muscles. It should look impressive, carrying himself with confidence and powerful movement, which should be buoyant and unencumbered despite its size. They are often called Velcro dogs, always wanting to be with their owners, and so are not prone to wandering off on their own. Boer Bowls are known to be especially loving and protective of their human children. They are excellent guardians, though they can be overprotective. Socialization is necessary for Boer Bowls, as they can be aggressive towards other dogs, especially those of the same sex and breed. In March 2019, a 60-year-old Verulam man was left seriously injured after he was attacked by his 3-year-old Boer Bowl. In 2002, Romania prohibited the import of the Boer Bowl and restricted ownership to those with a court order allowing them to own the dog. In 2010, the Boer Bowl was banned in Denmark. In 2011, Russia designated the Boer Bowl an especially dangerous breed, subject to mandatory registration and certification. Ukraine has classified the Boer Bowl as a dangerous dog, subject to mandatory microchipping, muzzle, and civil liability insurance. The Boer Bowl is also banned or prohibited in France, Fairfield, Malaysia, Qatar, Switzerland, Mauritius, and Bermuda. Importation of the Boer Bowl is illegal or banned in Singapore. Currently existing dogs must have insurance in the amount of not less than $100,000. Denmark. Currently existing dogs must be muzzled and leashed at all times in public. Romania. Owners must be at least 18 years of age and be certified psychologically fit to own a dog of this breed. Tunisia, Faroe Islands, Turks, and Caicos. Number 4. Wolf Dog. Not to be confused with the wolf hound, the wolf dog is a canine produced by the mating of a domestic dog with a gray wolf, eastern wolf, red wolf, or Ethiopian wolf to produce a hybrid. There exists an admixture, as there are a range of experts who believe that they can tell the difference between a wolf, a dog, and a wolf dog. But they have been proven to be incorrect when providing their evidence before courts of law. As with many things, reality is not so simple. Wolf dogs are perhaps the most misunderstood, and any would argue, mismanaged, animals. Advocates of wolf dogs say they can be wonderful pets, while opponents argue that they're unpredictable, untrainable, and inherently dangerous. What's more, there's no approved rabies vaccination for wolf dogs. Of the most bizarre incidents, in March 2018, a Virginia's family wolf dog hybrid killed their 8-day-old infant and had to be put down by sheriffs. The wolf dog has been the center of controversy for much of its history. And most breed-specific legislation is either the result of the animal's perceived danger or its categorization as protected native wildlife. 40 U.S. states effectively forbid the ownership, breeding, and importation of wolf dogs, while others impose some form of regulation upon ownership. In Canada, the provinces of Alberta, Manitoba, Newfoundland, and Prince Edward Island prohibit wolf dogs as pets. Would you own a wolf dog? Leave a like and let me know in the comments below. Number 3. Rhodesian Ridgeback. The Rhodesian Ridgeback is a dog breed bred in the southern Africa region. The Rhodesian Ridgeback's distinguishing feature is the ridge of hair running along its back in the opposite direction from the rest of its coat. They require consistent training and correct socialization, and are often not the best choice for inexperienced dog owners, for they are strong-willed and competent dogs. In October 2017, Astrid Palmer sustained wounds to her left forearm after she was bitten by a brown Rhodesian Ridgeback dog at a friend's home in Billerica. Ireland, Italy, UK, and Switzerland all forbid the ownership and importation of the Rhodesian Ridgeback. Number 2. American Bulldog. The American Bulldog is a large breed of utility dog descended from the now extinct Old English Bulldog. They are now used on animal farms, dog sports, and for showing. They are part of American culture and history, and may be used as a cultural icon for the United States. They are generally represented as being strong and tough. They bond strongly with their owners, and are happiest when their masters can shower them with time and attention. They are not as friendly, however, with people they do not know. In November 2016, three children and an adult were hospitalized after being attacked by an American Bulldog in Manchester House. The dog was seized by the police. They are banned or restricted by cities in Arkansas, Colorado, Missouri, Nebraska, New York, Ohio, Oregon, Texas, Washington, and West Virginia. 1. Doberman. The Doberman is a medium-large breed of domestic dog that was originally developed around 1890. Dobermans are known to be intelligent, alert, and tenaciously loyal companions and guard dogs. Personality varies a great deal between each individual, but if taken care of and properly trained, they are generally considered to be loving and devoted companions. The Doberman is driven, strong, and sometimes stubborn. In February 2019, 66-year-old Elaine Rickman was found dead in her backyard with dog bites on her face, arms, and hands. Two adult Doberman pinschers were located inside the home. In Australia, USA, Argentina, Canada, and Ireland, one requires special permission to own and import the Doberman. And that's it for the 10 most illegal dog breeds.